This is a slightly different video than I usually do, and I have COVID at the moment, and I'm talking about my experience, what happened during these 7 days. Yeah, my symptoms. Little thanks for recovering, not too much, but this is mostly about my experience. I'll talk where I got my information from. Definitely the NHS site is a precious resource. Some videos that approach the explanation, what the virus does, the testing, and even treatments and other alternatives. Well, I don't go too far in there, but they give good information. Don't trust some random guy that did a video in YouTube. Okay, each case is a case. So I'm going to do an explanation from day one to day seven. Doesn't mean your symptoms evolve in the same way or even feel exactly the same thing. Can be a different experience for everyone. So just to have an idea of my background, I'm almost 40 years old, general healthy. I don't take any medication or anything else. I'm triple vaccinated, including with the boosters. I had a kind of mild COVID because I didn't have a severe COVID. Doesn't mean, and just because it was mild COVID doesn't mean it's easy COVID. Mainly the 6 and 7 days, I was suffering. And for a few moments, I was not feeling really right. Short moments, I doubted if I needed a hospital or not, but it was not required, and now I'm in a recovery path. Just to add, my wife presented the symptoms slightly earlier. I was testing negative, and when she got first positive, 3-4 days, I started having the first symptoms. So that was a good thing, because when she was really unwell, I was okay-ish. And when she was recovered, I was unwell. Now, talking about the symptoms, you can see in the NHS site, put some of the symptoms here. They don't have an order or anything, so I'm just going by days in my explanation. First to second day, mild sore throat. Nose block a little bit, but this time of the year can happen to me. I didn't consider it too important, to be honest. Energy levels were fine, appetite fine, and I was like, okay, this should be an easy trip. Some people say they don't feel anything. I just forgot I'm slightly older. Hey, so with age, your innate immune system doesn't work so well, and the innate immune system is really important to combat this virus. I suffer a little bit more than just some mild throat and other things. Yeah. Third day, I started having more pain in my throat, starting to have sweats and some shivering. Temperature was fine, general weakness, but I still could do like some activity. The night, I lost my sense of smell just for a few hours and kind of come back in the next day, so it was a bit weird, but that was one phase. Fourth day, this is not going to be the easy, right? More throat pain in the joints, nose completely blocked, smell was gone, weakness, I get tired with very small activity. The fifth and sixth day, that's when things start getting a bit worse. My breathing was not great. My nose was completely blocked, but sometimes I was like, mouth breathe. It's not great. Temperature of 38, sweats. I have to change the bed sheets a few times during that day. My heart rate, I got some bracelet and I check it. Normally when I rest, it goes between like 55 and 60, even less sometimes. I was going 80 to 90. That's normal when I'm walking or active. So that was like big difference for me. Depends where is your baseline, but for me, that was a big difference. I couldn't lie down completely flat. I would just start coughing, my breathing becomes a bit hard, so I spend most of the time sitting, and I slept sitting. My lungs would hurt too, very tired. I would do something, wake up, 3 spoons of breakfast, and just go to bed, and I was exhausted. Or just lie down on the sofa. And of course, no smell. Yay. And I think this is where things get a bit more specific for people. Mine was quite neck pain, maybe sleeping, sitting down is not the best option. And a lot of pressure in my, I think it was my sinus cavities, in this side of my eye. A lot of pressure in this side. Oh, not very pleasant. Couldn't eat, no appetite at all. What I could manage was fruits, orange, mangoes, apples, those things. I loved it, munching on them. But food, I couldn't really feel it. I didn't have sickness or anything like that, but I just didn't feel like it. I watch a lot of resumes of movies in movies during these days. That's what kept me distracted from the pain. And few moments I was thinking, maybe I need to go to the hospital. I don't have an oximeter to see my levels of oxygen, but sometimes I was just sitting down and I was like hyperventilating. And I'm like, why? Do I feel breathless or something else happened? Or a cough was just continuous. I was like, okay, let's see how things go from here. But normally people between the 7-8 day, that's when things go, start getting better, or they go to a hospital. Beware too. It could be early for some people and later for others. Don't say, oh, it's a 7 and 8 day. In my case, it was. This means for everyone. Some research that points in that direction, but don't stick on, oh, 8 day, 7 day. Improve or hospital, beware, okay? All indication of an edge. 7 day, my energy return, but the rest was there. Coughing, nose block, my appetite come back too. My heart rate was still high, but started coming down. And I was feeling less tired. So things start going in the right direction for me. Of course, my voice still here didn't change at all. At this moment, I was feeling complete relief. Okay, no hospital for me. I can stay at home to open my windows, clear the air. My wife was practically okay at this moment. There's probably like a difference of 4 or 5 days between us, between the first symptoms. So 89 day, I'm still positive when I test. So not great. I'm still coughing randomly, less tired. I could do some exercise, but my level of energy are going back to the normal. I lost 1 kilo. You know, some people will be like, oh, great diet. Not great for me. Gaining weight is really hard for me. And at this moment, yeah, probably I'm recovering. My sense of smell did come back. Returned, so it was quite short loss.
How to do a COVID-19 self-test rapid antigen test.
See, this video explains all the procedures quite well, and even with the new test kit, they're not free anymore. You need to go Boots or other pharmacy and buy them for NHS and people that work in healthcare or in the government side. I still keep them, but you need to swab things properly. If you swab in your mouth and your nose, you need to do the proper technique. He explains in the video. It does explain some people will swab the nose and be negative and swab the throat and be positive. So be aware about that. And the other mistake, in this case, my wife did not on purpose. Most of the tests, you can see the result after a few seconds, but she left the test out. And after an hour, she came to see and the two traces were there. She was positive. She was thinking she was negative. So we had to repeat everything again because too much time was passed. So as they say, do the swab, you do the test, and then you wait 30 minutes and then you see the result. Don't do it like before or after, but it's true. Most of the times after a few seconds, you can see your result. If you want to know how these tests work, watch this video. It explains the chemical reaction and the components. I think it's really funny if you like to nerd about these things. Why you can be triple vaccinated and still catch the COVID virus. You get vaccinated, there's a reaction to your immune system and antibodies are produced. Antibodies just recognize the virus. If the virus is trying to enter the body, it will lock on it. And after being locked on it, the virus cannot invade your cells, multiply, give you the disease. And we'll call this one the BA2 that I was vaccinated against. And let's call the BA4, the one I catch. So the problem after being even triple vaccinated is now the BA4. You can see these things we call antigen, a square. So the antibodies are expecting a triangle. So when the virus comes around, it tries to recognize it and say, oh, it doesn't fit. So carries on, locks in your cells, multiplies, gives you the disease. And then your immune system needs to react and do everything again. Produce new antibodies, these ones, that fit in the antigen. And now it can be neutralized and send alarms and all the system combated. But you're going to get all the symptoms that I've been describing. Now you think, oh, catch the vaccines, I've been sick, I'm free. Well, not really. The more people that catch the virus, the more it multiplies and the more variants you can have. I was a triangle, this is a square, and this is, I don't know, strange shape. So now you got the strange shape and you need to do everything again because now these ones will not be recognized and these ones will not be recognized too. So we will get in and your body multiply, give you the symptoms again, and that can happen after a month or less. So still take your cares. Use a mask if you're coughing, please. You protect the other people, object jackass. Talking a little bit about long COVID, many people feel better after just a week or two. Most people will be fully recovered in a space of 12 weeks. But some people go beyond that and the symptoms can last even longer. I'm not yet in this space, but after almost 4 weeks, I got like an irritation in my throat and I cough. But I cough a lot to the point like people look at me and like they're scared. It's nothing to do with my lungs. They're all clear. It's just my throat. And I just scare people when I start coughing because I would be scared if I see someone coughing like this. Most people I talk, they always talk about brain fog, tiredness, still the loss of sense of smell after many, many weeks. I'll leave you the NHS side about the long COVID in here. I'll leave you this side of the NHS too. You got all the long COVID symptoms very well organized. In my case, I'm drugging the cough one. Irritated throat. Use mask. God, there's my cough again. Cannot really talk much. Bye-bye, everyone.